In this lecture, we will do what is the charge which is required to be given to a soap bubble to double its radius from R to 2R. This is a soap bubble having the radius R and initial pressure inside is say P0, outside pressure is PA. We know the formula of excess pressure of soap bubble is P0 minus PA is equal to 4T upon R. I am not deriving that formula. I think most of you already know it. I would like to cover the other aspects of the problem. And now this is the excess pressure formula when you do not have any charge on the soap bubble. When you have charge on the soap bubble, there will be additional pressure pushing the bubble out. Suppose you take any sphere and suppose there is nothing inside, no. The only pressure which is exerted is because of the charge. How that pressure emerges, let us see. Now let sigma be the charge density plus sigma be the charge given to this sphere. This charge density will be uniform. Q was the charge and sigma will be Q upon 4 pi R1 square or R2 square, whatever. Now I want to know what is the pressure exerted by this charge. This pressure will be exerted when you take you can find out that, just take a small, I have put a lecture on this separately, but still I am repeating it. Take a small segment here. I want to know what is the force on this segment. This is a small segment. What is the electric field just here in the vicinity? If you see, what is the electric field because of this leftover portion? This is a leftover portion. This portion is a leftover portion, huge portion. What electric field it is producing here in its vicinity? That we can find out. Let that electric field be E dash. This, I am saying only this portion. Don't get confused. You will say electric field inside this shell has to be zero. Yes, it has to be zero. We are going to use that. But I am saying electric field because of only leftover part. What is the electric field near its vicinity because of this part? So it's like a thin sheet having charge density plus sigma. What is the electric field? Is sigma upon twice epsilon. So electric field which is downwards is sigma upon twice epsilon. The electric field here has to be zero. So whatever is downward twice sigma upon twice epsilon and upward was E dash. The resultant has to be zero, means E dash has to be equal and opposite to this. So E dash has to be of the same magnitude. So the electric field in this vicinity due to the leftover part is sigma upon twice E zero. So what will be the force on this part in this segment which we are considering? Force will be, let the area of segment be ds. What is the total charge? Sigma ds. And what is the electric field? Sigma acting on it, sigma upon twice E0. This is the electric field due to the leftover part on this segment. So the force exerted here will be this much. What is the pressure? Pressure is force upon area. So pressure is sigma square upon twice E0 epsilon. So this is very easy. So pressure due to, there is a pressure due to charge on any charged surface, if even it's a conducting spherical spherical body or it's a spherical shell. So the pressure due to the charge is sigma square upon twice epsilon. So when there is charge and when there is no charge, there will be difference. When there is no charge, this is the formula. And when there is a charge, the pressure inside is P0 plus sigma square upon twice epsilon. This is the additional pressure which is there because of that charge on the sphere. This is like as if you have increased the pressure inside because that charge is pull. If you see, look at this sphere. Because of these charges, there is an effect of stretching. It is like being stretched because these are all repelling each other. These are all same charges. these are repelling each other, so there is an effect of as if there is some pressure inside. So an additional pressure is built up. Suppose there is a pressure P0, so additional pressure you have to always take into account because of the charges. So now your formula becomes P0 plus sigma square upon twice epsilon P0 dash. Let me write P0 dash here. P0 was initially, and minus PA plus 4T upon R2. This is how my formula emerges when you have the charge. Without charge, this was the formula. With charge, this is how you have to write, because pressure inside will rearrange. This is the total pressure available with me. This is the outside pressure which you have to subtract. And this is your formula for the excess pressure, which formula remains the same. Only thing is one part has been added here. So just keep this thing in mind. Now R1 is R. This is 4T upon R, and R2 is 4T upon twice R. We are also assuming that when this increases its size, the volume increases, there is no change in temperature. In such problems, this assumption you have to make. Take it as an isothermal process. So there is thermodynamics also. So P0 and the initial volume is 4 upon 3 pi R cube is equal to P0 dash 4 upon 3 pi 8 R cube, because radius is double. So P0 dash is nothing but P0 upon 8. So write the value of P0 dash as P0 upon 8. So multiply this whole equation by 8. This becomes plus 4 sigma square upon epsilon. This becomes minus 8. And this becomes, you multiply it by 8, it becomes into 4. Now you subtract these two equations, so you get 4 sigma square epsilon. These will get cancelled. Minus 7PA. Minus 7PA if you subtract it, and there it will be 16 minus 4 is 12T upon R. So I have done the basic job. So my sigma square is coming as epsilon upon 4, 12T upon R plus 7PA. Or I can write it as epsilon 4R, 4, take R common here, 12T plus 7PA into R, sigma square, or my sigma will become, this will be root epsilon upon root R, and this is 1 upon 2. Now what is my sigma? Please be careful in such problem. It says what charge has to be given to the sphere. So I give the charge here, charge I had given here, but this charge resulted in the increase in the radius. So the charge density has to be found as Q upon 4 pi by this area, this radius. Don't find the charge density with this, because the arrangement has changed. You gave the charge here, but it has increased its size. So it is 4R square. So sigma is Q upon 4 pi into 4 into R square is the value of your sigma. So it becomes, and here it was 2, sorry, this 2 was there, it was 4, so 2 was here when you had taken the square root. So it becomes Q is equal to pi times 8 into R into root R, this is how I can write it, into epsilon root epsilon into 12T plus 7PA into R raised to power 1 upon 2. So your Q is 8 pi R into R epsilon 12 T plus 7 P A R raised to power 1 upon 2 is the charge which is to be given to the soap bubble to double its radius.